RCIA, which is stands for the Rite of Christian Initiation of Adults, and specifically adults. These would be people who very often would have, some cases would maybe have been baptized, but had gone no further, had drifted away from the church through probably lack of association with people in the church. Others then might have never had any background in Catholicism, so becoming in almost green. And then you'd have other people who might come from other churches who would have maybe received baptism and maybe communion, maybe not received confirmation, but even might have received confirmation. So there's all different fields of where people are coming from and their backgrounds.
I desire to please you, so as not to leave you, and I hope that I will never do anything harm.
He will teach you everything and remind you of all that I've said to you. He's going to continue the work of what Jesus had begun in his life. And in the Gospel, we all speak according to John.
Jesus said to his disciples, "If anyone loves me, he will keep my word, and I've experienced the peace like that the world doesn't understand. You can't explain the peace that you have in a situation where there seems to be turmoil all around.
It's also divine. It's amazing when you come across that in the creed later. So it's setting up. It's kind of setting up as is unique. He will teach you everything and remind you of all that I've said to you. He's going to continue the work of what Jesus had begun in his life and being with you on your journey. So it's kind of a nice title. And the Father will send, again, you know that word send, will send.
There are 6 to 7 people who help, along with myself, in the group. We have, I suppose, evolved and just kind of stayed in the past year. We were using the same people that are coming on as assistants and helpers, who would be people who would be strong in their own faith, yet are ordinary members of the church, but have a very, it means a lot to them. And I suppose the value of the RCA, you'd be saying we're there to teach, I suppose, people are coming in. And we have these meetings each week on a Thursday for usually an hour and 15 minutes, and then a cup of tea afterwards. The meeting, I suppose, generally it follows the Sunday gospel of the Sunday coming. That would be the back, that we'd study that in detail. And that's generally been that, but of late we've been trying to incorporate, say, the creed, which we've done now tonight. That would be what we're trying to get done now before the end of May. So it's a mix of what do you call it, scripture and catechesis. So my own background would be, I did some theology for a couple of years. The other people in the group would have done catechesis. Some people might not have done any courses, but they have their life experience to come to them, so that's where so that's a great help. We also have meetings with other groups in Cork under the direction of Anne Francis and Father Declan Mansfield, and we usually meet up in the cathedral office there. So that kind of keeps us in touch with other what's happening in other groups. But very much just kind of left up to ourselves to develop and evolve. And I suppose the big benefit of it is that we have, it's been more benefit to us in that it forces us to look up things and to check things and to learn about our own religion that we probably wouldn't have done if we hadn't had the opportunity of doing this. So it forces us to kind of understand better what we say we believe. And I suppose that would be, so that's, and also the positive of people coming into church. I suppose we learn a lot of people leaving, but it's great positive thing for people to be coming to church, and particularly in this era when there's so much going on in the church. That is a very, it's uplifting and it gives us all hope. And that's the big thing about it, it gives us hope.